Hello, the internet. Welcome to our ongoing video series, Smartphone Tips, all about mobile advertising on AdWords. My name is Sean Quadlin. I'm a product marketing manager here at Google, focusing on AdWords best practices. In other videos in this series, we've talked about engaging with mobile users, whether that's through your ad text or through ad extensions. In this video, I want to talk about capturing the unique value that mobile users can actually provide to you and your business. Mobile users behave differently from desktop users in a lot of different ways. And a big part of that is actually the way that they convert. So before we talk about the different types of conversions mobile users might be experiencing with your site, just be sure that you have conversion tracking in place. It's a simple step, but if you have different mobile site from your desktop site, losing that pixel is going to lose a lot of insight for you. So be sure that you're tracking conversions for mobile website visitors. All right, alongside with website visitors, there's a bunch of different ways that mobile users can actually interact with your business and show that they're interested in what you have to offer. So I want to talk about the different ways that mobile users can connect with you. If they visit your site and actually take action right on the website, this is, you know, straightforward. It's a website conversion. A converted click, conversions in your account, you're well used to this. So be sure you're tracking that like we just talked about. If somebody wants to do research on mobile and then actually convert later on, once they've kind of vetted you on their desktop, whatever, if they have just a different context, that's called a cross-device conversion. That's going to show up in your estimated total conversions column. It can be hugely insightful, hugely helpful, and hugely valuable. So be sure you're looking at cross-device conversions. Some people just like to do business over the phone. If that's the case, you can track calls as conversions, and we'll talk about that in a bit more. But if somebody wants to use a phone call when they're on their mobile phone, be sure that you're tracking calls as conversions. Additionally, a mobile user can download your app. They can get value out of that, whether it's in-app purchases. If it's just an app download, you know what that's going to be worth for you. You can track that and optimize to that. So think about all the different ways that mobile users can actually connect with your site. There are all these different types of conversions that you can track. You should definitely do whichever ones make sense for your business. Track that conversion if it can be a conversion for you. And we talked about estimated total conversions a bit earlier. And I want to reinforce how important it is to regularly look at this column so you can see what type of engagement your site is driving. You can just segment your reports by conversion name or conversion category to see what type of engagement you're seeing. And if you use this as your basis for optimization, it's going to be a clearer picture of the value that mobile drives for you. And then the final thing I just want to talk about a bit again is using Google forwarding numbers. If you use Google forwarding numbers whenever you're driving calls, it gives you the ability to actually set up calls as conversions. And so you can determine which threshold users need to cross to actually become a valuable phone call, track that as a conversion, and then it's going to make your optimizing that much easier in the future. So when it comes time to actually measure the value that mobile users derive from you and your site and what you get from them, ensure that proper tracking is set up, a basic type of thing, but really important. Track all of the potential mobile conversions. We talked about different ones. Be sure that you're capturing anything that you offer. And finally, use Google forwarding numbers to track calls as conversions. So when we're talking about the full value of mobile, those are some things to keep in mind. But please check out the rest of our video series for some other smartphone tips.